Hello friends and welcome to Time Classes. Today's topic is bar charts in data interpretation, and the handout that we will be using is DIHO 3531902. I am sure that you have this handout along with you, and even if you don't, it's perfectly all right because I'll be posting each question on the slide. In order to get the most out of these lectures and these classes, I suggest that you keep a rough copy on the side for some quick calculations and also a fair notebook to take down notes as we discuss things in the slides. One very important thing for any topic in data interpretation is that you spend the initial part in understanding what is the data. If you have understood the data correctly, then the answering of the questions will be faster, whereas if you don't read it very carefully, then when you go to the question, then you come back to the data, then you go to the question again, back to the data, and the understanding remains incomplete for the duration of answering the question. So on that note, let's begin today's lecture. Okay, in the topic of percentages and profit and loss, there is a certain term that we use for some quick and smooth calculations, and it is called as the multiplication factor. The formula associated and that will be useful for you are the following. And that is that the selling price SP is equal to multiplication factor M times CP. If I were to write selling price in terms of profit, I would write it as SP equal to profit into M divided by M minus 1. If I were to write the selling price in terms of loss, then it would be simply loss into M divided by 1 minus M. So this is mostly the same formula. You don't need to remember it separately. Because for the case of profit, let's say there's a 20% profit, then your multiplication factor would be 1.2. And if it's a, let's say, 30% loss, then your multiplication factor would be 1 minus 30 by 100. That's 1 minus 0.3. That's 0.7. We need to maintain positive values, and that is why M minus 1 would be positive when there is a profit, and 1 minus M would be positive when there is a loss. In case you are not aware of these things that I am discussing, simply write them down, and these are what you will be using in the questions to come. So if you are given the cost price or the profit and the profit or loss percentage, then directly the selling price can be calculated. So from the first formula on your screen, you get that the cost price is equal to selling price divided by M. And the profit can be written as SP minus CP, where SP is M times CP. So you would get profit equal to M times CP minus CP, and that is M minus 1 times CP. Please write this neatly in your copy. Profit equal to SP minus CP equal to M times CP minus CP, which is equal to M minus 1 times CP. So all of these formulae are interrelated, and you can directly derive any of them. The next one is that now you had profit in terms of CP, now you can get profit in terms of SP, and that would be SP into M minus 1 divided by M. Next, loss would be 1 minus M into CP. Now, if you are wondering how did we get this particular formula, then in this one, simply substitute CP equal to SP by M. So you will get M minus 1 divided by M into SP. So all of these are interrelated. And similarly, the loss would become 1 minus M into CP. Both of these are connected. They're exactly the same. Profit and loss are more or less the same thing. And in terms of SP, again, you get 1 minus m divided by m into SP. Okay. Please write all of this down, the formulae on the left. These will be useful for your chapter on percentages, profit and loss, and for one of the question sets that I will be discussing with you all today. So let's proceed. I'm going to take an example to show you all that these formulae do work. And in such a case, those of you who have never heard of a multiplication factor or don't know what it is, that will also be clarified. So let's take an example. Let's say that the profit is 20% and the cost price is 160 rupees. Then we know that the multiplication factor would become 1 plus the profit percentage, or in the case of a loss, it would become 1 minus the loss percentage. So we get the multiplication factor as 1 plus 20 by 100, and that is 1.2. Now you have CP and you have M, and I'm going to obtain the selling price. SP is equal to M times CP, that is 1.2 into 160. So 1.2 is what? It's a 20% increase. Yes. So what would be 20% of 160? I will do this in two steps. I hope you all are writing down. What is 10% of 160? 16. So what would be 20% of 160? That's 16 into 2, 3, 32. So therefore, cost price increases by 32 to become 160 plus 32, that's 192. So using this formula, SP equal to 1.2 into 160, you get it as 192. I'm going to repeat this for those of you who got a little confused or were unable to write it down. Basically, I find out the multiplication factor, that is 1 plus 20 by 100, that's 1.2. Now, SP equal to 1.2 into 160. So either you can do a direct calculation. When you remove this decimal, it becomes 12 by 10 into 160. That's 12 into 16. So 12 into 16 is going to give you 192. The other way to do this is 1.2 implies a 20% increase on 160. So what is 10% of 160? That's 16. What is 20% of 160? That's 16 into 2, 32. So the selling price increases by 32 to become 192. Now I have all the values. I have profit, I have cost price, I have selling price. I'm going to try to use some of the other formulae to see whether they work or not. So I want the profit. Now we know that profit is going to be selling price minus cost price. So I can see that 192 minus 160, the answer should be 32. But let's say that selling price was not available to you and only cost price was there. Then how do you calculate? You would use this formula, profit equal to M minus 1 into CP. So I get 1.2 minus 1, that's 0.2 into 160, that is 32. So this formula is correct. Let's speak a little more slowly. Okay, let's try another formula. The formula that I want to try is this one. If I have the selling price of 192, can I get profit directly? So 192 into 1.2 minus 1 divided by 1.2. That turns out to be 192 into 0.2 divided by 1.2. Now this is 6. 0.2 by 1.2 is 6. Sorry, 1 by 6. So I get 192 divided by 6, which is equal to 32. So profit in terms of SP formula is also correct. Now let's try getting the selling price from the profit. If I have a profit of 32 rupees and I want the selling price, then I can use this formula. So let's see if it works. 32 into m divided by m minus 1. So what do you get over here? 1.2 divided by 0.2, that is 6. So 32 into 6 is 192. So you can see that each one of these formulae in one step can give you the answer. I hope everyone wrote that down. I'll go back again for you all to note down if anything is pending. Okay, so let's continue. We begin with your handout. And the first thing that I will ask you to do is take 30 seconds to simply read what is the data and what is provided to you. And a bar graph basically constitutes these kinds of bars or towers given in the question. And these are what are used to represent the data. And in this question, you are given the profit percent earned by a company in the years 2012 to 17. Like in the previous question, I took a profit of 20%. So there, similarly, in this question, you are given a profit percent in a particular year for the company. So the x-axis is the name of the year. And the y-axis is the profit percentage. And now please take 30 seconds to solve question number one. Also try to do it in a single line or using only one single formula or calculation. So let's look at this question. The question says that income earned by a company in the year 2015 was 64.8 lakhs. What was the expenditure incurred by the company in the same year? So in 2015, you have a profit percentage of 35%. So that means your multiplication factor becomes 1 plus 35 by 100, that's 1.35. And what do you need to do? You have income, which is similar to SP. You want the expenditure, which is similar to CP. So I can simply write CP in terms of SP and get the answer. And we saw that CP is equal to SP divided by M. Or basically, SP equal to multiplication factor times CP. So I say that let the expenditure be E lakhs. So E into what is this? This is 1.35, the multiplication factor. E into 1.35 is equal to 64.8 lakhs. This is what you had to do. And you simply calculate this to get 64.8 into 100 divided by 135, and your answer is 48 lakhs. So you see, in a single step, we have been able to get the answer without using any profit percentage formulae, profit percent equal to profit upon CP into 100. Then you get profit, then you subtract profit from selling price to get the answer. That is too many steps. But here, in a single step, by writing SP in terms of CP, we have been able to get the answer. So let's move to the next question. In which year was the profit maximum? Please take 30 seconds to answer this question. You are given the profit percentages for each year. So in which year is the profit maximum? I want you to look at the formula that we wrote in the previous slide. Please open those formulae. And for profit, we looked at two formulae. See, one is SP minus CP, that's fine. The others that we looked at was SP was profit in terms of the selling price and profit in terms of the cost price with the multiplication factor involved. You had profit in terms of the selling price and profit in terms of the cost price. And the multiplication factor is, as we know now, obtained from the profit or loss percentage. So I'm going to repeat. We have profit in terms of selling price and profit in terms of cost price. But in this question, neither are you given the selling price nor are you given the cost price. So you cannot find out the profit. And since you cannot find out the profit in any particular year, you cannot compare profits, and that is why the answer would be cannot be determined. Since the expenditure incurred by the company is not given, we cannot find the profit in any year. And what I want you to write in your copy is that we have profit in terms of SP and profit in terms of CP. But we have profit in terms of SP and profit in terms of CP. But in this question, neither SP nor CP is given. Hence, we cannot find out the profit. I hope this is fine. So let's move to the next question. If the profit earned in 2012 was 14.25 lakhs, what was the income earned in the same year? Now, this is a very straightforward question. You have the profit, you have the profit percentage. What was the income in the same year? Please solve. Use the formula, find multiplication factor, quickly calculate. Okay, let's solve. What is the formula? We have SP equal to profit into M divided by M minus 1. And in 2012, the profit is 30%. So you get SP equal to profit into. Now, what is the multiplication factor? 1.3. Yes, this is 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1, 0.3. So 1.3 divided by 0.3 is 13 by 3. So this is 13 by 3. So there are, we are writing, we can also write it in a percentage form. Your, for example, the multiplication factor here is 1 plus 30 by 100. So I can write that as 130 by 100. So multiplication factor 1.3 divided by 0.3. That's 13 by 3. And we solve this to get 61.75 lakhs. And that becomes your answer. So it's a very, very easy calculation because this 14.25 is divisible by 3, will easily get cancelled out, and then you multiply by 13 to get the answer. So this question is a typical demonstration kind of question to show you how quickly questions based on sales and revenue, profit and loss, SP and CP can be solved very, very quickly. So let's continue. The next question, please take 30 seconds. Read the question carefully. The expenditures are the same. Find the ratio of incomes. Okay. So if your expenditure in 2014 is E and the profit is 20%, what would be the income? Income would be 1.2 into E. And in 2016, you have a profit of 50%. So income would be in 2016, you have a profit of 50%. So your income would be 1.5 into E. Yes. So you simply have 1.2 into E divided by 1.5 into E. That's 12 divided by 15. That is 4 by 5. So your answer turns out to be 4 is to 5. You can write this down. Okay, let's move to the next question. It's the last question for this data. Income in 2013 is the same as income in 2017. If expenditure in 2013 was 32 lakhs, find expenditure in 2017. Think which formula should be used and try to get to the answer. Take 30 seconds. Let's solve. So income in 2013 and 2017 is the same. And I also have my profit percentages for 13 and 17. So that means I can write that income in 2013 equal to income in 2017. And both of these can be written in terms of the expenditure because we know that income is equal to M into expenditure. Yes. M into expenditure. So that gives me, I can write 32 in 2013 at a profit of 40%. So I get 32 into 1.4, the multiplication factor, should be equal to the expenditure in 2017 into 1.6 because you have in 2017 a profit of 60%. 32 into 1.4 equal to E into 1.6. Solve to get the answer. So you get 32 into 14 equal to E into 16. 16 will get cancelled out. You get 2 into 14. So the answer should be 28 lakhs. Single step questions in one step is done. If you know which, if you are clear with the formulae. So you just keep all the formulae in your mind and it will come up. Automatically it will come up because you were given that the incomes were the same and you were given the profit percentages. So obviously you write income in terms of the expenditure and you get to the answer. So let us proceed. Okay. First, please look at the data. Focus only on the data. What is the data saying? The data is saying that it is a frequency distribution of teachers in a town according to the number of children that they have, that they are that they have as students. So the teachers are either men or women. Surprisingly, the number of men is much more than women. And the number of teachers teaching only one student, there are 200 men teaching only one student, and there are 100 women teaching only one student. In the second case, there are 300 men teaching two students, and there are 150 women teaching two students. So the teachers over here are completely separate from the teachers over here because you cannot have a teacher teaching two students being counted in the category of teachers teaching one student. These teachers are separate, these are separate, these are separate, these are separate. And so you can easily count the total number of teachers in the town. So this is what the information is give, provided to us. This is what is the information provided to us. And now you can solve the question very, very carefully. What is the difference between the number of men teachers with at least three children and the number of women teachers with at most two children? Please take 30 seconds. A very straightforward question based on counting only. Okay, let's solve. So I want the number of men with at least three children, that is the number of male teachers teaching at least three children. What is the meaning of at least? At least means not less than three teachers. So that means not less than three students or children. So What are the categories that are not less than three? It could be three or four or five or six. And I want the number of men teachers. So the number of men teachers would be 225. The number of male teachers teaching three children, I simply look at the bar, I look at the level. It is between 200 and 250, so it's 225. Next, the number of male teachers teaching four children is 175. Just check carefully till you watch the arrow, 175. Next, you have 75 and another 75. So 225 plus 175 plus 75 plus 75 is the number of men teachers with at least three children. 225 plus 175 plus 75 plus 75, that is 550. And next you have at most, the number of women teachers with at most two children. At most. See, please write this in your copy. At least equal to not less than. At most equal to not more than. At least equal to not less than, and at most equal to not more than. So, at most children means not more than two children, which means the number of children should be one or two. So, the number of women teachers teaching one child is 100, and the number of women teachers teaching two kids is 150, 300 to 450. So you get 100 plus 150. Number of women teachers with at most two children is 100 plus 150. That is 250. Now what do we need to do? Find the difference between the first category and the second category. So you get 550 minus 250, and the answer is 300. The answer is 300, option number A. So let's move to the next question. Please take 30 seconds. A very straightforward question. Okay, let's solve. So we need to get the ratio of the number of male teachers to the number of female teachers. Okay. So where are the male teachers? 200 plus 300 plus 225 plus 175 plus 75 plus 75. Those are the male teachers. 200 plus 300 plus 225 plus 175 plus 75 plus 75. These are the male teachers. Similarly, you get the female teachers, 200 to 300. That's 100 plus 150 plus 125 plus 75 plus 75 plus 25. Let's look at it again. 100 plus 150 plus 125 plus 75 plus 75 plus 25. Now, actually, by this time, see, when you keep doing something repeatedly, you become more efficient at it. So I have already noted that one of these, the difference between one of these lines or two of these lines is 50 units. So I am actually not even looking at the y-axis. I am simply counting the number of such groups. So I get one pair here and one pair here. So I get 50 plus 50, 100. 50, 100, 150. 50, 100, and this is half. So 125. 1 plus half, so 50 plus 25, 50 plus 25, and only 25. So you get 1050 is to 550, that's 105 is to 55, and you divide by 5 to get 21 is to 11, that is our option number D. The answer is option number D. So you can see that the questions are really very straightforward, but you have to understand the data. What is the data providing you so that you do not get confused? So let's move to the next question. What is the total number of children that the teachers could have? Or what is the total number of students that are being taught by all of these teachers? Where this bundle is teaching only one student, all these teachers are teaching two students each, all these teachers are teaching three students each, and so on. Quickly calculate. Okay, can I say that? This bundle of teachers is teaching only one student. So 300 teachers are teaching only one student. So the number of students is 300. But these 450 teachers are teaching two students each. So the total number of teachers being taught is 450 into 2. These 350 teachers are teaching three students each. So total students being taught is 350 into 3. Similarly, 250 into 4, 150 teachers teaching 5 students each. That's 150 into 5 and 100 into 6. That is the number of students being taught. And so you get 300 into 1 plus 450 into 2 plus 350 into 3 plus 250 into 4 plus 150 into 5. Plus 100 into 6. So you get 300 plus 900, 1200. 1200 plus 1050, that's 2250. 2250 plus 1000, that's 3250. 3250 plus 750, that's 3300. 3300 plus 600, that's 3900. We see that 3900 is not in the options, so we calculate again. Let's start over. Let's go a little more carefully this time. 300 plus 900 is 1200. 1200 plus 1050 is 2250. 1200 plus 1050 is 2250. 2250 plus 1000 is 3250. 3250 plus 750 is 4000. 4000 plus 600 is 4600. So your answer is option number C, 4600. Please write this down. Okay, let's move to the next question. Tricky question. Please solve carefully. Read carefully. What is the question asking for? Okay, let's begin. So there are two things. One is men teachers with two children and women teachers with four children. So men teachers with two children is 300 and women teachers with four children is 150. So you have 300 and 150. Sorry, you have men teachers is 300. Men teachers with two children is 300 and women teachers with four children is actually 75. So you have 375. So the question now, let's reread it. 300, what percent of 300 is 75? Or if I were to rephrase this, I can say that 75 is what percent of 300? So you have 375, and the question is 75 is what percent of 300? So you get 75 divided by 300 into 100. That is 25%. 75 is what percent of 300? That is 75 by 300 into 100 is 25%. I hope this is okay. This is a very easy set, and I'm sure you all are able to follow what is happening. So let's go to the final question for today. What is the average number of women teachers with one, two, three, four, and five children together? Please take 30 seconds to understand and see what this question is asking. Okay, let's discuss. Okay, now you must be getting confused when it's asking for average, then what to do because you have one student here, two here, three here, four here, five. So let me rephrase this. Let's say that I have 5 years, 2011, 12, 13, 14, 15, and these are all marks. And I ask, what is the average number of marks in these 5 years? Then what will you say? Sum of all the marks divided by five. It's a very, very similar case. You are given five categories, and it's saying what is the average number of women teachers with these five categories together. So, what are the women teachers? 100 plus 150 plus 125 plus 75 plus 75. And you want average, so you divide by five. What is the average number of women with these one, two, three, four, or five children together? So, you simply get 100 plus 150 plus 125 plus 75 divided by 5. And the answer is 105. So you do not need to average out the children as well because these are simply categories. So this is where we stop for today. In today's class, we have understood how to interpret data given in the form of bar graphs, and we have learned that you need to spend the initial time just in understanding the data, because if you are able to understand the data given to you, then solving the questions will be much easier. The next thing we learned is in questions related to SP and CP or profit and loss or income and revenue, then there are certain formulae that can be used for quick calculations. I also need to tell you that all of these formulae, let me go back a little bit. All these formulae are based on our basic formula that profit is calculated on CP. That is profit percent equal to SP minus CP divided by CP into 100. And that's how we get all of these results. Okay, I want you to write down clearly in your copy that all of these results are derived from, or all these results are derived assuming profit percent equal to SP minus CP divided by CP into 100. And you already know this formula. The reason that I am telling you this is that there may be a data set given to you, and below that, a formula may be given. For example, it may be given profit percent equal to SP minus CP divided by SP into 100. Then these results will not hold. And in that case, you can simply proceed by the normal method of calculation rather than using these shortcuts. I hope this is fine, that these formulae are based on profit percent equal to SP minus CP divided by CP into 100. If any other formula might be given or provided, then these results would not be valid. These results would not be valid. And with this, we stop today's class. I will see you next time in part two, and that is where we will complete the rest of the handout.